good. Now, the new sword. Operation. Well, Wolf is the TFO, so we're going to go with.
Jolan True. Starfleet has taken custody of a high-profile person of interest at one of their research facilities. Curiously, when interrogated by agents of Starfleet intelligence, the prisoner refused to speak to anyone but you. A fascinating
response, to say the least. Now, this is interesting because of the fact that
Starfleet has requested your assistance, of course.
Something where
I want you to comply with that request. I am quite interested to learn. This prisoner will only discuss with an officer from the Republic.
And I'm wondering just how far they went in tailoring this particular mission grant dialogue for the various factions and sub-factions. Well, let's go find out. Go to the Izar system. Which is the other side of the galaxy.
Jolan True, our scouts have found an attack.
Yeah, the chance we're here to do Charybdis. Want to talk to the trade freighter? It's actually something that you'll see quite a lot in this game. Is that anytime there's a huge number of people piled in the same spot, someone has a trade freighter floating around.
Oh well.
Anyways. This is way, way, way to the north. I do remember that this system was here before. They just hadn't done anything with it. If I remember, it's something from TOS. It's the planet that Garth of Izar was from or lived on at some point. I'm not sure exactly. And of course that happened. Yep, I heard that this was an issue that would come up with that someone had with this, but it was something that they're like, well, this is something that happened. I have no idea why, but it happened. And yeah, it happened. Because the fact that that's
we
the time
you.
Where
the Terrans,
you would have expected to have seen
so
a cutscene if there was
not sure how they found a station with a classified location, but here we are. Nice shot.
starting to wonder if the Black is building ships. That would just suddenly bring from 50% to zero.
Warning. Ship is under attack. Target shield has failed.
That one had like 4 or 5 maybe NPC ships shooting at it. Of my fighters and whatever else. Now, this is something...
Glad you turned up. Things were going sideways fast. The Terrans really did a number on the station. Our scans show they're running on emergency power and batteries. Most of their critical systems are down.
This is something that we actually saw in the preview trailer for this thing. Is a Federation starbase built into the side of an asteroid. Well, both sides of the asteroid, I guess.
Yes, we noticed that as well. They made surgical strikes on a number of key targets, but didn't do enough damage to destroy this. Excellent. I'd go in weapons hot if I were you.
So, this is one of the new interiors that Taco Fangs was working on recently, which is very, very, I guess you could say, Terran Empire themed. Now, this is an interesting thing because it's an alien of a race that, well, it looks like the sort of thing that you would get if you made an alien character like this one, and then just hit the random button. Like, the canon race looks most like, I don't know, Doctarians maybe? I'm not sure. This, standard Elkars. Okay, so, Taco Fangs in his discussion things for the 2409 interior kit stuff talked about this, and this is one of the new hallway assets he made, or I guess wall panel assets, and this too, I guess. This all does not look entirely it doesn't look exactly like what he was working on in his streams, but it looks very familiar. Alright.
Commander Kyle DeSoto, Starfleet Intelligence. Thanks for coming. We can really use your help.
Looks familiar.
They're fine. The brick. This way! We're lucky you made it out here.
Help you.
Things were looking pretty grim. Hey, this way.
These are obviously Terrans because they don't have sleeves. So, this is a version of his new Starfleet interior map that is dark and also battle damage.
Hey, this way.
Yeah, shut up.
Hard to say what the Terrans are after. Could be a number of things. Could be after any one of the classified projects, or all of them.
It doesn't really feel like a place with classified projects. It feels like a boring... I don't know what. It's just hallways, no obvious purpose.
Afraid the turbo lift's offline.
Need to use
the Jeffries tube to get down there.
It's hard to be sure what race this person is. They don't have any distinguishing traits that mark them as not human that I can see. So, who knows?
Watch out! There are still some hostiles here!
Do I want to save the Citadel? No, not really. It's probably machine critical or something.
get through here. See that lower panel in the... He's stable. Once we get comms back up, I'll call for a medical team.
Now, this is interesting because this is obviously something that goes with some that one of the new art assets he did, because you're looking at this, you know, I wouldn't obviously think Axis Man, but it is what the sort of thing that, that stuff like this got used for in TNG.
Engineering's over here.
He even had a lever
this
that
way.
Moved. That's neat. And here we have a broken conduit
Damn.
Inside another one of those.
They're still things. Here, too. Take them down. Stop whatever they're doing.
Enemy combatant
in close proximity. Yeah, that
sounds good. Ouch.
Yeah, that roaring noise is, I have the Katra Stones ground trait, so my character will sometimes do a psionic counterattack just because people shoot her. Fun trait. You done yet? Seriously?
Hey, this way.
What now? So, this is that fusion reactor dingus that Taco Fangs was working on, which is like a multi-story structure. You look down here, you see another catwalk, and it's the second catwalk, and third or fourth or something. Can I jump down the hole? No, of course not. Which is a good thing, because, you know... Wait, who's using that? Giving one of my bridge officers that power. And I definitely don't use it. Let me double check that. Nope. Oh, I did give it to Nissus. Okay. So, my... Kavali is doing that. Okay.
Looks clear. Let's get to work.
Turn on the fusion reactor. No, this is definitely, definitely not going to blow up. Not that much. Okay, this panel here just screams an isolinear chip rearrangement minigame. I have to say, I like the fact that there's also a... But that does not look like a properly functioning reactor.
Damn! A couple of EPS conduits were fried!
To the second floor, where things are getting electrocuted. Does that seem like a good idea? I mean, I would probably turn them off and then, you know, figure out why
okay.
It's electrocuting.
There are two consoles.
First.
Work smart, but work fast. We need to get this under control.
I like that we can, like, just, like, look through the glass panel on the floor. And see what's down there. However, this kind of screams hazard that will electrocute you if you get too close to it. Hmm. Eh? This is a turbo lift. Interesting. This is climb down, but okay, the mission objective marker is pointing at the staircase. Why? Yeah. It's definitely pointing at the staircase. Yeah, this doesn't appear to be anything interactive. This is interesting, because bridge officers don't normally do this. But here, they're just literally standing there. So the mission objective marker is pointing at... I genuinely don't know what I'm supposed to be doing here. Really? That's where the objective is? The backside of the fusion reactor on the second floor? Why was the mission objective marker pointing at the ladder then? This is a neat touch, though. Blinking lights in several different colors. Okay, then. Oh, hey, what's this? Hey, it's another ladder going up that we can't use. Hey, a different set of blinking lights. Authorized personnel only. By order of blah 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 blah. Oh, these are cool. Those are exocomps bolted to the wall, though. And one of the mission rewards is an exocomp. That was strange. For a second, my bridge officers appeared here and then stopped being here. Oh, this is interesting. I hadn't noticed that the first time. Multiple green blinking lights above there showing that it's a working turbo lift. Okay, so if my guess is right, being in through here will not kill me. This really looks like this is the sort of thing that should kill you, though. I mean, seriously. They've done things in previous episodes where you have to, you know, like, avoid...
Enemy targets on sensor.
Okay. I apparently got lucky the first time. Ha! No more flashlight. Oh, wait. Why is this mission objective marker pointing at the stairs? So this is actually like the thing on Kobali, where you have to wait for the lightning bolts to go away before you walk through it. Although, in this particular example, only part of the
nice work.
Lightning bolt cycle
power's back, and the EPS is locked down and in the green.
Part of its
all right, there's a console near your position. Use it to bring internal sensors.
Or maybe it's just that if you're far enough away, closer to the wall, it just misses you or something. I noticed that these blinking lights didn't change, though. Even though we have, you know, lighting. Still can't use this. So what actually changed? Okay, this is now interactable.
Ops to all hands.
Ooh, that is
We're
cool.
We're detecting hostiles at the brig.
It changed from
hostiles at the
brig to that.
That's not good. They must.
Hmm. for the turbo lift. Yeah, the one I was looking at earlier. Maybe this time I can actually go into the turbo lift. That's cool. It actually doesn't appear to have had the interior of this change at all. Okay, obviously I'm supposed to go left and kill those guys. Oh, it's over this way.
A sight for sore eyes. The Terrans have us pinned down here.
Remember the mission. Failure is not an option.
What Terrans? They just fell over dead. No one that way. A locked door. Actually, oh, right.
Oh, I see you got my message.
Yeah, that's it.
Enemy target on center. Personal shield. Yeah, I noticed you took your sweet time to get here, though.
Here on my face. Yeah, that was the super saturated contra stuff thing. Blinking yellow and orange lights for a locked door, I guess. Oh, hey, it's this thing again. Now, it's interesting that Taco Fangs put these, like, red emergency blinky things, which it makes it extra creepy when you don't have those, because it means you don't even have emergency lighting, you have, like, no power at all, which is cool. So, this is also one of the things he was talking about in one of the streams, is like building a Starfleet issue prison cell. So it's, you know, like something where it doesn't look obviously uncomfortable. Here we have what's probably the bed retracted into the wall. Maybe like the two beds, like you can choose which side of the room you want to sleep on today or whatever. Actually, that's an interesting point. Oh yeah, see, here's one where they're not retracted. They don't look particularly comfortable, but I suppose, you know, get a pillow out of one of these things. Here we obviously have a food replicator. This is basically the way they were always on TNG. These are, I think Taco said that one of these is basically what they have. It's have like a miniature toilet type shower thing. And this, I don't know, dresser for clothes or something, maybe. And here we have all, well, this basically looks the same thing. I wonder if it says the same blinkies on there. Yeah, it would, well, maybe. I'm not 100% sure if that's the same blinking light pattern. We have a smaller version, where there's room for one bed and two of the three things. I guess the shower and the, All right, so here we have the Starfleet personnel who were supposed to be guarding Leeta and making sure she doesn't escape, who got shot by the Terrans and are probably dead. This is an odd looking one because of the fact that, what race is that person? Again, this looks like someone hit the random button in the alien generator. And here we have the control console for the cell.
I have to say, I was beginning to think you weren't coming. Why the delay? All-you-can-eat buffet at Quark's?
This is interesting because the fact that they obviously redid her face quite a lot. This is not the way she looked previously to this, and I'm not sure why.
Explain myself. Oh, honey, we do not have the time. Absolutely! Only an idiot wouldn't be... You're skeptical. I can see that. Fine. Even someone like me has to answer to the Emperor. Does it matter? I'm here. Let's move on. I had access to the Emperor's tactical plans. He means to conquer everything in existence, and he believes this weapon will help him. Correct. I found out about this place some time ago. It's close to a point in space where the barrier between... I'm usually pretty good at covering my tracks, but I was in a hurry. Some of the Emperor's best got wind of my snooping around and decided to put a stop to it. And me.
Mirror Kumarki worked for Lita, and Mirror Kumarki...
Captain Kumarki. She's all... not even a little. They were here to silence me. Permanently.
I see you've met the prisoner. I've been able to restore most of the critical systems, but we still... There is a turbo lift around the corner from you that will take you...
Oh, hey,
don't
Dad.
You dare leave me here! Where are you going?
This is interesting, because that one was blinking yellow, I think. Yeah, or at least from a distance, it looks like it's blinking yellow. It's a different shade of gray. Seriously. It's not actually where I'm going. Must be this door. Hey, it's no longer has the orange things on it. That's cool. The circuit pattern that suddenly appeared on my character model is the same one that the temporal, their clever hack or whatever thing does. Oh, hey,
how delightful. I seem to have acquired a new nemesis.
Yeah, that I would call it that. So, interacting with the door was a hidden map change? Oh wait, no, that's right, never mind, I went down the turbo lift. That was the map change. Now these are interesting because they're these giant computer console things, which, like many computer consoles in Star Trek, are a flat pane covered in blinking lights. Seem to be anything here other than decoration. Wait a second, something's hitting me up.
Thank you.
how much of a ridiculous pain in the ass it is. This is actually one of the standard science captain powers. It's just that, one, I hate using it as a science captain because of the fact that it can backfire on you, and two, having it used on you by enemies has a very low chance of actually backfiring because of the fact that you're probably not going to be around anything that isn't going to die soon anyways.
I'd love to stay and slay, but duty calls, I'm afraid. Until next time.
Really?
Looks like the mainframe was compromised. Check the next console and verify the status of the backups.
So, how bad is it?
Wait, he brought Leda. Why did he bring Leda? This door isn't locked, why? Oh, I can't go through it.
The system's been wiped! Damn!
Right. Oh, that won't be necessary. It generates a trans-universal portal between our universe. The prototype was installed on the Khonshu.
So, you're going to blindly chase after her, aren't you?
Well, that was an interesting timing. So, there's an area back here that probably exists solely for decoration that we can't get into because there's an invisible wall blocking it. Bummer. Also, what? Why? Oh boy, this area down here, that is, yeah. We've seen stuff like this in Star Trek.
So, you're going to block. I hope you're ready for a.
The transit devices are up and running.
She's as predictable as a warp core breach.
Alright, here we go.
Warning. Ship is under attack.
This was just getting started. And for another, you know, wait.
Warning.
their shield generator. Want to pull them down to the station and get your data back. We need to move fast. The data labs are on a different deck, and they'll be coming for us.
Attention, all hands. A traitor and her pets have arrived. Do bring me their heads, won't you?
Now, you're in
well,
for being...
that was quick. Still, this is a Terran station, and Terrans aren't terribly fond of taking orders from aliens. We might find a useful ally in...
Okay, so basically Lita's saying that we should look to see who else has pissed
I'm
off.
I'm gonna claim the glory for this one!
That's interesting, because that one looks yellow from this angle. Okay, this is definitely telling me that I can kill these guys. Okay. Okay, one's yellow, one's orange, and one's red. And the red one is the blinking one. Now this is interesting because the signage is actually different and has a different logo on it. Sanctioned officers only, blah blah blah. It's just orders from the enforcer required personnel. Okay. Also note that the wall texture here is different. Has a diagonal cross thing. And different carpet too. Although the carpet's not exactly flat. It's kind of like a weird texture to it. Like certain parts of it are a quarter of an inch above the other. Like they're not exactly on the same surface. Someone literally shot me in the back.
Okay. Enemy targets on sensor.
Thank you.
Let's see what he has to say. I'm dying to hear how he wound up in the booth.
Are you the leader? Okay, so potato, Synthale, and the Lavinian meat. Honestly, the only one of these is actually with any value is the Lavinian meat. And it's not even all that much of value. You know what? I'll just make Nita hold them all. She's not actually doing anything anyways. Now that would be amusing, having the bridge officer version of Nita and the current story NPC at the same time. This is what I was saying, though, about how they changed the Nita character model, though, is that it just... This is the way that the story is used to look versus the way she looks now. Definitely a marked difference. I'm not sure why. Also, the hair is different, too. Hair and the face are both different. This is, of course, a completely different Terran uniform, but, you know, that's different uniform is different uniform, I guess. Oh, yeah. She actually comes with a Bajoran phaser pistol, if I remember right. Okay, time to talk to this guy.
You. Figures Grumarke. She's been using Terrans as lab rats, testing the Emperor's new toys on them. Wasn't right. No Terran should be put to death by alien scum like her, or the Bajoran traitor behind you. I tried to stop her. As you can see, that didn't work.
Well,
the Emperor is obsessed with that stuff. Thinks it'll make him invincible. Has something to do with
it. Boring conversation, anyway.
Wait, did Lita kill him?
Looks like Kumarka used the agonizer to keep poor DeSoto quiet. When I'm really looking forward to that.
But yeah, as anyone who has an agonizer field generator knows, you can use agonizers to kill people. Yeah, just die already. Anyone else to kill? No? Okay then.
Perhaps I wasn't clear earlier. Kill Lita and her thugs. Now!
Yeah, this build is kind of like, I guess you could say, psychic ramp. I'm just gonna pick this stuff up so I don't have to come back for it. Oh, there's only like one or two guys left.
Me handle that lock, Chief. I can crack it like an egg. Just make sure I don't get shot.
What you in the back, other than these guys who just
enemy target on
Duncan. The mortar firing on? Yeah, it has to be enemies in the next room. Yeah, there. See, this is the mirror version of the same research lab map we were in before. Now,
enemy
that is actually the downside to using quantum mortars, is sometimes they will force you to fight enemies before you're actually...
Oh, locked you out, didn't you? You could. Oh, that exocon. Yeah.
I was already expecting angry company. I don't know if there's anything in down here that looks different. Well, I mean, it's filled with orange mist instead of blue mist. It's somewhat different. Oh, hey, these things again.
Exocop, Legum, Creel, ready to receive new instructions.
Wait, remember the Exocop you get
Exocop self-actualization subroutines halted. Provide specific instructions.
Data's heading to the console at 9 o'clock. Get it before it's lost!
Oh, that's what that thing's for.
Keep it up! There's more to go!
That's an odd way of...
Data's heading to the console at 5 o'clock. Get it before it's lost!
Yeah, that's not. That's not even.
Keep it up. There's more to go.
I'm gonna guess it's this one next.
Data's heading to the console at 1 o'clock. Get it before it's lost. Keep it up! There's more to go! Data's heading to the console at 5 o'clock! Get it before it's lost! Keep it up! There's more to go! Got it! Finish off our uninvited guests so we can get out of here! Data's heading to the console at 1 o'clock! Get it before it's lost! Damaged. Get it back online.
Okay, that's
the clock's ticking here. Stop messing around.
It has a mechanic for you need to protect the NPC.
Data's heading to the console at 9 o'clock. Get it before it's lost.
Exocomp is still freaking damaged. I thought they fixed the Exocomp already.
Enemy target on sensors.
The clock's ticking here. Stop messing around.
Right, this doesn't apply to him.
Data's heading to the console at 9 o'clock. Get it before it's lost! Keep it up! There's more to go! Got it! Finish off our uninvited guests so we can get out of here! Alright, we have what we came for. Take the exit. Great! Now let's get out of here.
This is one of those things that amuses me. It's probably the most useful instant rank engineer power you can give the bridge officer, because the fact that it's a turret. For some strange reason, bridge officers don't get turrets until lieutenant rank, normally, except for this one. Okay, time to put things away. Snail roast egg. It's actually used for one of the winter advance recipes. So it actually has some value because of the fact that replicating it is not exactly easy. This, on the other hand, I don't know of anything that actually uses that. Oh well. Anyway, it's some deal.
All right, we have great. Now.
This is how I'm like, okay, so which step of this process is when Lita betrays us?
Welcome back. That's good news.
Oh, the Brookhaven fleet of Terrans.
Like the 14 sacred trees of Lugar, I am invincible. Make peace with your gods.
That's what you say. Isn't that what people usually say that by the energy?
Concentrate fire on the Brookhaven. Until it's down, the Scala cannot be damaged. Caught a break. We'd better get back to our universe before she returns with a full Terran armada.
Sorry, but, why am I worried about that?
Right. We'll open the portal. Okay. We're all set here. Just give the word when you're ready.
Whatever.
You're all clear. Get through the portal.
Right.
There's no more time. Go! Attack it! target the lead cruiser and fire at will.
It wasn't a good day for the DeSotos of either universe.
Where is it? It's one of these things. That's not the right one. I think what it is actually that I'm doing... Yeah, it's normal difficulty. I'm doing normal difficulty in a ship that's capable of doing advanced TFOs with relative ease, so, you know, it's not exactly a major challenge.
Ooh, touched a nerve, did I? Sorry about
that. Nice to see you, though,
Nicolay. Look, it wasn't all... you didn't think I'd stop when I collected your data, did you? What did I say earlier? Knowledge is power. And based on what I saw...
We read you. We're only picking up one ship out there, though. Understood. That's good to know. Thank you.
If I might make a suggestion, let's take our prize somewhere with a lot more defenses than this station. Kumarke might come after us. Again.
The Starfleet crews that were lost did their duty. It falls to us to ensure that the data you brought back will bring meaning to their deaths. I am surprised at the level of cooperation you received from Admiral Leda.
The fact that the Mira DeSoto got
whatever up to
killed right before
terrible.
He was about to tell us what
Alliance
it was.
Intelligence is working overtime to decrypt
and
the data
like,
you recovered
oh,
from
that's
the Terrans.
He was boring
the exocomp
anyways.
You
I get the feeling Leda knows and she's not telling us.
Soon, we will have more insight on the Emperor's plans.
Oh, hey, look. This is a duty officer, I think, isn't it? Alrighty then. What? My duty officer roster. Yes, I do have one space. Good. What does this thing do, anyways? Active roster power ground. On a flanking attack, provides a chance to deploy an exocomp that will provide fire support. It will remain in the field for a while before transporting away. Moderate internal cooldown. 20% chance, and the exocomp will stick around for 45 seconds. Interesting. This is definitely a very generic one, because this is basically anytime you shoot someone in the back, or stab them in the back, actually. This is any attack, not just ranged attacks. And the quote is a portal reference. Oh, well. But yeah, this is a very interesting duty officer reward, because it's a new duty officer power that's literally something anyone can throw into any build for any reason and have it actually do something. Whether it's a good option or not, I don't know how much damage it does. That's the main question there. Oh, well.
If I might...
Let's see if there's a cutscene when you warp out. This is different.
And so they run home, tails between their legs. They probably think they've won. Poor deluded fools. We have everything we need from them. The location of the Emperor's prize is now known. He will be most pleased. Make sure all is ready for the next stage. Soon, we will strike. For the glory of the Empire!
Okay, that's hilarious because of the fact that, it just doesn't quite look right.
Jolan True, our scouts are...
That particular pop-up with Detan for Skylight Charybdis covers the entire Alpha Quadrant. Yeah. Or most of it, anyways. I'm not sure exactly how much of it. Anyway, though. Well, I was actually just going to be on to do a stream of the new story mission and talk about that, which is certainly something interesting and definitely is setting up a long... Oh, hey, look. Karen Gambit. Firewall. Yeah. Which makes me think that this is hinting that we're actually going to end up meeting the Terran Emperor. Especially since, you know, it's a whole... It's about the Terran Empire as a whole and not just Admiral Leeta's armada. And especially the fact that it's related to fighting within the Terran Empire about that. Well, that's it for now. See you guys later.